Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hey, what's up? My name is Caitlin, and today we have what I think is going to be a pretty fun video. I've got a drawer full here of new products that I haven't tried, so we're going to do a full face of makeup products that I haven't tried, or pretty close to full face. I don't have an eyeshadow primer to try. I think that's it, so no new eyeshadow primer, but everything else today is going to be new. So let's just go ahead and jump right into this. The first thing I have to try is this little mini guy. It is the Smashbox Photo Finish Foundation Primer in the Radiance shade finish. I don't know what you would call it. So I have tried the, I think it's just called the original of this, and I do really like it. So we're going to go ahead and try this one. And I do have really dry skin, so I'm assuming a Radiance primer might be alright for me. And I am just going to put this off my fingertips because that's how I always apply primer. It smells a little weird. It smells pretty chemically. So this is gonna do absolutely nothing for my pores, but that's alright. I'm gonna glow today. I actually really like this. Hopefully that stays like that because I actually kind of really like this finish. So I'm just going to throw the products over there after I'm done using them. So if that annoys you, I'm sorry. And I am filming in a different spot today because I decided to be lazy and film on my bed. Next, we're going to go ahead and jump into foundation. And this is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Stick Foundation. And I did get it in the shade Alabaster, so I'm hoping this matches me. Because it is the lightest shade, and I am pretty fair. And this is what the packaging looks like. It's really, really nice, very luxurious. And I've never used a stick foundation before, so we're going to see how that goes. But I also have these sponges to try out. These are the Pure sponges. And I'm going to use the nut green one. I'm not going to wet it, because honestly, I never wet them. But we'll see. So that's what it looks like. Very, very white. This actually might be too light for me, and that has never happened. Let's just go for it. Oh, okay. I'm hoping this works. Go ahead and... yeah, we're actually just going to use a brush. I'm going to use the crown brush. This is the contour brush. It's what I always use for my foundation. Okay, so actually, maybe it's not too terrible. I don't know how I feel about this yet. It's kind of hard to blend. Which maybe it's like a quick foundation that you have to like blend it quick. Maybe that's my fault. That is pretty pale and kind of patchy. Let's go ahead and add some more over here and blend it like immediately. See if that helps any. Okay. Honestly, it matches my neck, but I'm looking pretty ghostly right now. I don't know how I feel yet. Honestly, I might even go a shade darker in this, but it's honestly not that bad of a color match. And it matches my neck, so I'm just ghostly pale, guys. I look kind of sick, though, in the camera, but in the mirror, I look fine. Okay, we're going to go ahead and move on to concealer. I do really, really love this packaging though. It's really pretty. And for concealer, I have the Tarte Shape Tape. I have not tried this yet, actually. And this is in the shade Fair. It is also the lightest shade. But honestly, I think it might be darker than my foundation. Oh, I'm looking real pale. Real pale. Okay. That is huge. Kind of a weird smell. Okay. it's a really, really strong smell. I think it is darker than the foundation. That's kind of funny. Okay. So, let's go ahead and use the Pure Sponge that I was going to use for this. This is a really hard sponge. I definitely think I need to wet it, but it's okay. Ooh. That blends out so effortlessly. Wow. I really, really like how this just blends out without me even like having to try. I can see why this is being so, so raved about. I'm gonna use my brush again. Honestly, I'm not really a sponge person. Like, they're okay. I just prefer to use a brush. Especially this brush, which this is designed for contour. So honestly, I don't really know if I'm hurting the brush by using foundation and cream products on it. But I like it for this, so. Okay, why do I look so much different in the mirror than I do on camera? Like, I look like a ghost on camera. But honestly, in the mirror, it doesn't look that bad. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and bake. This is the HD Finishing Powder by Studio Makeup. So, we're gonna go ahead and bake with that. And I did pre-open this because if you've seen any of my videos, then you know I suck at opening packaging. So I did go ahead and take off the plastic insert in here, just so you guys don't have to suck through that. So then use that. We're going to grab another pure sponge. Pick up the yellow one. And we're just going to make myself look like even more of a ghost. A strong smell too. Everything ate it. Everything has a really strong smell today. Okay. So, oh, I just got powder everywhere. Cool, cool, cool. While we're baking, I'm gonna go ahead and start on the brows. And I have a brow pencil today, which I don't really like brow pencils, honestly, because I have pretty thick brows. I just need to fill them in a little bit, but I prefer powder. But this is the, I forget what this is, Winky Luxe, that's what this is, brow pencil. I don't really know the name of it or the shade of it, so I'm hoping it matches me, but it's like triangular. I don't know if you can see that. I don't really know how to show you it. It's triangular, so we're just gonna go ahead and go for it. I love the packaging on this. Okay. It's a good color match. It's a pretty waxy formula. So I'm kind of like having to push pretty hard to get any payoff. That's okay. I don't really know if I'm going to be, I'm going to use the tip of it and see if I can get like a better point. Yep, went way overboard on that. Up there. Okay, so this is definitely more of a natural brow look than what I typically do. That's okay. I don't hate it. I don't hate it. Don't love it either, though. But I like a powdered brow. I like it to look like I did my makeup. I need a spoolie. Okay. I do like the shape of this because you can get like a really sharp point or you can do thicker strokes. if you just like put it flat, you can do a thicker stroke, and if you use the tip of it, then you get a more precise point. So that's pretty cool. Okay. This one's definitely thicker, so we're thicken this guy up a little bit. Looks semi-decent. Still really love this packaging, and I just realized that there is a spoolie in here on the other end. So we're going to go ahead and just play with this. Oh, this is a really nice spoolie. I do really like the spoolie. The brow product is okay. I mean, I don't love it, but I don't love pencils, so. And to set these brows, we've got the Pixie by Petra Brow Tamer. Here's this little guy right here. And I mean, it's just a brow gel, so it can't be anything too special. Here we go. The one thing that I definitely already don't like about this is I don't like the packaging, because I hate clear brow gel, because my eyebrows are so dark that it just makes it look disgusting in the tube. I love clear brow gel, but I hate clear brow gel tubes, is what I meant to say. Okay. There are the brows. Let's go ahead and dust off this powder. Hopefully this is not like super, super flashbacky. Okay. And then what's been in my hand this entire time? This is the Bare Minerals Invisible Light, and it's a duo, so it's got a matte side and a brightening side. So we're going to go ahead and finish setting the face with that. We're just going to use the same brush. We're going to use the matte side and just run that all over the face, just to set everything, make sure nothing creases, even though I have very dry skin, but I still like to set everything because I do get oily sometimes, just not very often. And then I do want to play with this side, the glow side. I'm honestly kind of intimidated by it because it's very, very sparkly. I don't know if you can tell, but it's very reflective. But we are going to play with it a little bit. So let's pick up a clean brush, hopefully. Let's use this little guy. And I'm going to pick up that on here. And I'm just going to put it like where I would put highlight. Okay, so that gives off a pretty nice glow. It's not like something super, super dramatic, but it's pretty. Okay, moving on. We are going to go into, what is next? Bronzer and contour. I don't actually have a contour, but I have this little guy by Ciate London, and it is a bamboo bronzer. I'm going to use this to contour, and then I'll use my bronzer palette after that. Oh, I forgot my contour. Or no, I didn't. Right here. Contour brush. So, here's this little guy, by the way. It's just a little small sample size from, like, BoxyCharm or something. Ipsy. One of those. I get them confused. Let's just go ahead and contour. Okay, yeah, that's a pretty decent contour shade. I mean, it's not the best, but it's also not a contour shade, so not too mad at that. That's actually really pretty. It would be a really beautiful bronzer. Always contour the lip. Hopefully this brings back some color to my face, because we are looking pretty pale. Getting into camera for this to hold my hair back. Sorry about it. I'm already at 15 minutes into this video. We're not even halfway done. I feel like this powder that I used, the Bare Minerals one, and it's in my hand, is going to be very flashbacky because you can kind of see like some residue down here. So for bronzer, I have this e.l.f. Quad. This is the bronzer palette by e.l.f. I have never used any of their bronzer palettes, or any of their palettes at all, but I did buy quite a few of them recently, so I did swatch all these too. Here is what it looks like. We're going to mix this really light shade and this darker shade, so I'm going to go mainly in here though, just because I have pretty fair skin. Bring some warmth back to this face. Okay, not mad at it. The other two in here, like this one, this one right here and this one are shimmery, so I don't love that. So we're gonna stay away from those ones. Sorry if you hear my brother yelling, but he is loud all the time. I feel like I apologize to you guys in every video I do because my family is loud. Okay. Definitely think this helped bring back some life to my face. Let's add a little more and put some blush on. This is the Leche Plus Leche, Leche and Gold Healthy Glow Rose Gold Blush by Seraphine Botanicals. And it just screws off like that. There it is. And let's go for this. Okay. Looks like it's super pigmented, so this should be fun. Yep, super pigmented. Okay. Oh, that's really pretty. It's kind of got a little bit of a, not really a sparkle, but like a sheen to it. Probably the gold in it. That's a pretty color. Put them a little bit more. I actually really like this blush. That's really pretty. Alright, moving on. So far, this video has been pretty decent. Okay. Highlight. This is where it's going to get interesting because this is the Rodeo Drive Highlight by Ofra. And as you can tell, it's very gold. So this might not look so great on me, but we're going to try it anyway. Because honestly, I've always wanted to try this highlight, so here goes nothing. Ooh. That's real pretty, but real gold. Honestly, I don't hate it. I really don't. I honestly thought I would. Absolutely. Hate it, but it's not as bad as I thought it would be. Like, it's not showing up super, super gold. It's more of like a white gold. So it doesn't look absolutely disgustingly hideous on my skin tone. At least in my opinion. Maybe it does and I'm completely wrong, but that's okay. I like it. Alright. I am enjoying this video so far. Now, let's go ahead and move on to eyes. And I don't have an eyeshadow primer, so we are just going to use this Too Faced Shadow Insurance that I've used time and time again. Oh, a little watery. That's okay. And then, for the thing I am most excited for, we're going to play with a new eyeshadow palette. Well, new to me eyeshadow palette. I have had this palette for a while now, and I've been waiting so long to film this video. So we're going to play with the Sweet Peach palette by Too Faced. I am so excited. I've literally had this palette just like sitting here waiting for like 2 months. Probably longer than that, actually. Here it is. I'm so excited. Okay. Okay, so tell me if I'm crazy, but I don't think this smells like peaches. Like, It smells like Runtz candy. If you remember Runtz candy, if you're a 90s kid like me, then that is what this palette smells like to me. But maybe I'm crazy. I also have two new brushes to try out, so we're gonna go ahead and try out one of those real quick. This is the Bodyography Pro. This is the flat shader. We're just gonna pick up White Peach right there and set the primer with that. Kind of a waste of a new brush using it to set primer, but that's okay. This seriously smells so good though. Like, I just want to eat it. I'm not crazy about the mirror in here though. It's kind of small, honestly. That's okay. So, no idea what I want to do, but we're just gonna play. Let's go ahead and start with Georgia down here and work that in the crease. They are kind of pick up a lot of kickback. So pretty. Like, literally, I've just put on one transition shade. I'm already like, this is so pretty. But they seriously, this shade at least is blending out so effortlessly. It's a really pretty color. I can't believe I've waited so long to play with this palette. I haven't played with any of the Too Faced chocolate bar palettes at all. I don't own any of them. I really want to buy them all. So you should let me know down below which one I should buy first because I really want to try them out. Okay, now let's pick up. I really want to play with this color, I think. I don't know. Honestly, let's pick up Just Peachy. Let's pick up Just Peachy first. On this brush, this is a Luxie concealer brush. I'll pick up Just Peachy and put that on the lid. Okay, let's spray this brush. We're gonna use the setting spray. This is the Project Beauty Spray Set Go, which I have not tried on my face yet, but we will later in this video. Let's spray it and then pick up Just Peachy again and see if that helps it. Yep, there we go. Definitely better. We're gonna go about halfway in with that. This look I do might not be totally wearable, but I definitely want to play with like a few colors, so we'll see how it turns out. Okay. This color is kind of playing me. It's not my favorite in the world. Yeah, I'm gonna use spray again. Hopefully that's not a trend for this palette, but the matte shade I used was really pretty. Okay, yeah, as soon as you spray it, it's so much better. Okay. Don't know about this shade, you guys. It looks pretty on camera, but alright, that's as good as it's gonna get. Now we're gonna pick up another fluffy brush and we're gonna pick up this really pretty khaki green color called Bless Her Heart. Because I really wanna play with this. I'm gonna run that over in the outer corner. Okay. Crazy, but does that look good? Okay. Okay, I'm going to take that same flat shader brush and flip it to the other side and pick up Candied Peach right here and see if I can build this up a little bit. Just in that center. Yeah, that's better. Go right up into the crease with it. Definitely a better color than just peachy was. Showing up a lot better, and it definitely has a lot of glitter to it. So it packs like a little bit extra. Going back into Bless Her Heart. And we're just gonna keep working this in here until we get it where we want it. It's a lot more of a brown than I thought it was in the pan. That's okay, I still like it. The shade you just have to work with. Yes, okay, not mad at that. This is kind of a weird color combination, but I kind of also really like it. What do you guys think of this color combination? Is it weird or do you like it? I kind of like it. But I'm also kind of weird, so. Okay. Now back into the same first transition shade we used, or transition brush we used. We're going to pick up Puree. Just to deepen that crease. Ooh, there we go. Yes, okay. I like that. I still look really pale, don't I? That's nice. Oh well. Now, let's pick up this little brush right here. This is from the Naked Smoky palette. I'm going to pick up Charmed, I'm Sure, on the smaller side of this brush. I'm going to work that right in here. Just in that outer V, just to give it a little more definition. And I'm pretty sure you can hear my sister now. I swear they just wait till I film and then start yelling. Siblings, right? I'm going to go back into Candied Peach and brighten this up a little more. I'm just going to put it over top of just peachy. Okay. I actually really like this eye look. So, let's take a little bit more of, or not a little bit more, but we're going to pick up this Luscious color. And I'm going to put that right on the center. Just to give it a little bit of a pop. Okay. Yep. That was a good move. I like that. Okay. Now we're going to take... It's a good inner corner highlight color. There isn't really a good inner corner highlight color, so we're going to take Rodeo Drive and use that as an inner corner highlight. I'm just going to pick up a little flat brush here. Oh, I just dug my nail. Just dug my nail into Peaches and Cream. That's cool. That's pretty. And I'm also going to put that on the brow bone. And I like to bring it all the way over to connect it. I know not a lot of people do that, but I enjoy it, so we're going to keep doing it. Now, we're going to try another new brush out, and this is the Bodyography Pro Angled Liner Brush. And we're going to pick up, let's do Delectable, it's this really pretty purpley color. And we're going to put that on the outer half of the lower lash line. Definitely have quite a colorful eye going on today, but that's okay. And then we're going to pick up Peach Pit, this other purple color right here. And put that on the inner half, just using the same brush. Staying close to the lash line. Okay. Same thing on this side, obviously. I do really like this color. I love to use purples on the lower lash line just because my eyes are green, so it makes them pop more. I'm enjoying this makeup look so far. Now let's go ahead and move on to mascara. This is the, well, I do have an eyeliner, but I don't think I'm going to use it just because this waterline's pretty dark. This is the ColourPop eyeliner in the shade Swerve. Hard to read. Okay, this is the Tarte Lights Camera Lashes Mascara, and this is a mini size. I have never used this mascara, obviously, because that's what the whole theme of this video is. So we're going to go ahead and give this a shot. That's what the wand looks like. It's pretty long, honestly. So let's just go right into this. Okay, so I don't know what this mascara claims to do, but it's definitely giving me some length. It's a little clumpy, but we'll see if we can fix that. And I didn't curl my lashes, obviously, but I never curl my lashes. So, okay. I actually kind of like this. I don't think I like it better than the Better Than Sex mascara, but it's a definite decent mascara. Yeah, I like that. Okay, let's put this on the lower lash line. I've honestly been looking for like the perfect lower lash line mascara. Just because my Better Than Sex mascara, which is my favorite mascara, I feel like the wand's too big. And because it's such a watery formula, it kind of gets a little messy on the lower lash line. This one is definitely a contender for that. This is pretty. Okay. I actually like that. I've said that like 10 times now. Honestly, mascaras are like the thing that's hardest to impress me, just because I really love the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara, so I kind of like hold every mascara to that standard, and honestly, I haven't found one yet that I like as much, but I do really enjoy this mascara. You guys will have to let me know of any down below that you really like. Obviously, I only use cruelty-free mascara. I have tried, I know some of you are probably going to say Benefit Roller Lash, but I have tried that in the past before I went cruelty free, and I did really enjoy that mascara, I'm not going to lie, but because I'm not cruelty free, I won't be using it any longer. So if you know any cruelty-free options that you love, please don't hesitate to let me know. Because I definitely enjoy trying mascaras. Like, eyeshadow palettes and mascaras are my favorite things to try out. Yeah, this is definitely a very lengthening mascara. That's not giving like crazy amounts of volume, but I like the length it's giving. I can see why it's a favorite of so many people. I go a little crazy on the mascara, not gonna lie, but it's okay. So there is Close Up. I am actually thoroughly enjoying it. Okay, you just stop putting on so much mascara. So I think we're about done, honestly. We'll go ahead and set the face, which we're going to use the Project Beauty Ready Set Spray that I showed you earlier. I really like the mister on this. Like, it's like one of those, I don't know if you can, no, you can't continuously spray. I guess I should show you, huh? But it's like a nice spray. Doesn't have a scent, which I am okay with. So there's that. Now for lips. I have three options. I have the Trifle Cosmetics Passion Fruit Lipstick, which looks really pretty, but I kind of want to go for a liquid lip. I have ColourPop Strut, and I have Girl Power Liquid Lipstick, Matte Liquid Lipstick by The Beauty Crop. What's it called? I'm a Boss. Honestly, I don't really think this is going to go with my eye look, but I think I'm going to use it anyway, just because I have tried the formula of ColourPop's, just not that color, but I've never tried this formula. So I think we're gonna do it. Ooh, it smells good. It smells kind of vanilla-y, but also kind of something else, but I don't know what that is. It smells really good though. Okay, it's giving me like Queen of Hearts vibes. It's definitely not plain about being matte though. It's like instantly matte. I actually really like this color. This is really pretty. It's really drying though. Like, I can feel the dryness already. So that might be a hesitation for you. But it doesn't feel like heavy. Like, you can do this and be comfortable with it. But it feels a little dry, not gonna lie. But honestly, not terrible with this eye look. So that is all of the products I have to try today. I do have some glitter, but I don't think we're gonna use it. So here is the finished look. Overall, the foundation I think might be a little too light, but I think when winter hits, it'll be okay. Sorry, I'm like staring at myself. The concealer was amazing. I do really like that concealer. It blended out so easily. It kind of smelled weird, but it blended out really easily, and my under eyes look pretty good. So I do like that. The setting powder was okay. It smelled weird, which is like a theme in this episode. Episode, whatever. But it was okay. Like, it's definitely keeping me feeling matte right here, so that's good so far. I feel like the Bare Minerals powder might have some flashback to it, but we'll see about that. I'll let you guys know in like an upcoming video how it worked. I really like this highlight. I didn't think I would because it's very golden, but in the pan anyway. Like, where's the pan? I lost it. Oh. Sorry. Like, in here, it looks a lot more gold than it does on the face. So, I didn't think I was gonna like it because I thought it would be too dark for my skin tone, but it actually looks pretty decent. The brow powder, or not powder, but the brow pencil, I'm not in love with, but I knew I wouldn't be just because I don't really like brow pencils. But the brow setting gel is pretty cool. I really like this blush. It's like a natural blush, but still really pretty. The bronzer was cool. I mean, it's nothing like too special, but it's there. It's all right. I like this little guy better than the e.l.f. palette, but definitely more for bronzer, not for contour. So from now on, we're gonna use this as a bronzer. And the eyeshadow palette I really liked, except for the Just Peachy color. Not a fan of that one. Didn't really show up as much as I wanted it to, but for like a natural eye, it's really pretty. But the rest of the shades, I am really enjoying. I kind of wish it had more of a a brow bone highlight color, but that's all right. What else is on my face? The setting spray, I really enjoyed the Mister. I honestly think I'm really gonna like this. It is pretty pricey though, so that's a downfall. And as for this lip, so far I really like it. Doesn't seem to be like streaky or anything. Yeah, it's really pretty. Definitely very matte. I think I might do one more layer of it just to see how it layers. But yeah, overall, I'm happy with the outcome. So you guys will have to let me know down below what you do and don't like of this tutorial and what products I should try out next. So that is all I have for you guys today. Don't forget to subscribe before you go and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss out on my videos. Bye, guys.